Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain about graphs.
What is a graph?
A set of vertices and edges is known as graph, and it is represented as g equal to v comma e, where v is vertices and e is edges. This is an example for graph where a, b, c, d are the vertices and a, b, b, d, c, d, c, a are the edges. Next is types of graphs. First is directed graph. In directed graph, directions are given to the graph. So this is an example. Here A is directed towards B and B is directed towards C. A is directed towards D and D is directed towards E. This is about directed graph. Next is undirected graph. This is opposite to directed graph. Here no directions are given to the graph. This is an example for an undirected graph where A, B, C, D, E are the vertices and no directions are given here. Next is weighted graph. If all the edges in a graph is labeled with numbers, then it is said to be weighted graph. Here this is an example. Here every edge is labeled with numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So this is about weighted graph. Complete graph. A complete graph is a graph if there exists any pair of vertices in the graph. Here this is an example for complete graph. Here all the nodes are connected to each other, so this is known as complete graph. Representation of graphs. There are three types. They are set representation, sequential representation and linked list representation. Set representation. In this, two sets are maintained. They are set of vertices and set of edges. Here set of vertices are A, B, C, D and set of edges are A, B, BC, CD, AD and AC. Next is sequential matrix. There are two methods. They are adjacency matrix and incidence matrix. Adjacency matrix, here this is an example. The vertices are A, B, C, D and E. Here the edges are represented in the matrix. Here for A to A, there is no loop or edge, so it is written as 0. For A to B, there is one edge, so it is written as 1. And for A to C and A to D, there are edges, so it is written as 1, 1. For A to E, there is no edge, so it is taken as 0. Next, for B to A, there is one edge, so it is taken as 1. And for B to B and B to C, there are no edges, so it is taken as 0, 0. And for B to D and B to E, there are two edges, so it is taken as 1, 1. Next vertex is C. C to A, one edge is there, so it is taken as 1. And for C to B and C to C, there are no edges, so it is taken as 0, 0. For C to D, there is one edge, so it is taken as 1. And for C to E, there is no edges, so it is taken as 0. Next is vertex D. Here A to D, one edge is there, so 1. A to B, edge is there, so written 1. C to D, one edge is there, so written 1. Here for D to D, there is a self loop, so it is taken as 1. And for D to E, there is one edge, so it is written as 1. Next is vertex E. There is no edge between A and E, so it is written as 0. From E to B, there is one edge, so it is taken as 1. And from E to C, there is no edge, so it is taken as 0. From E to D, so 1 is taken. And for E to E, there is no edges or no loops, so it is taken as 0. So this is about adjacency matrix. Next is incidence matrix. Here this is an example where V1, V2, V3, V4 are the vertices and E1, E2, E3, E4 are the edges. We have to represent the matrix between vertices and edges. Here E1 is coming towards the V1, so it is taken as minus 1, where E2 and E3 are coming outside of V1, so it is taken as 1, 1, and there is no connection for V1 and E4, so it is taken as 0. Next vertex is V2. Here the only connection is E1, so it is taken as 1, and the remaining are the zeros. Next is vertex V3. Here V1 direction is towards V3, so it is taken as minus 1. And V3 direction is towards V4, so it is taken as plus 1. And the next vertex is V4. Here, E3 and E4 are coming towards the B4, so these are taken as minus 1 and remaining two edges are taken as zeros. So this is about incidence matrix. Next is linked list representation. Here, this is the graph with vertices 1, 2 and 3. First, take the vertex 1. It is connected to two nodes, that is 2 and 3. Next, vertex is 2. Here, the 2 is connected with two vertices, 3 and 1. So, they are represented in the nodes. And the last vertex is 3. It is connected with the vertices 2 and 1. So, these are represented in the nodes. So, this is how a graph is represented in the linked list. So, this is about the today's class. Thank you.